A transformation is a change that you make to a shape or an object in a specific way. You specify very precisely exactly what the change will be. We use the word object to refer to the original shape that you started with, and the word image to refer to the new shape you get by applying the transformation. The object is the original shape, the image is the result. There are two basic kinds of transformations that we'll look at in this video. Congruent or isometric transformations that preserve the angles and lengths of the shape, and size-changing transformations that preserve angles but change all the lengths in the same ratio. Remember, the word congruent means exactly the same. Isometric just means same size. The congruent transformations are translation, which is a move or a slide, rotation, and reflection. We'll look at each of these in turn in a moment. And changing the size by a specified factor is called enlargement or reduction. Translation means to move or slide an object. You specify the move either by a distance up or down and a distance left or right, or you can specify the distance to go in a particular direction. For example, suppose I asked you to translate this shape down 2 squares and right 3. You would simply do exactly that. Take the shape down 2 squares and then across 3 to the right. The image would look exactly the same as the original. Remember, this is an isometric transformation. The image will be congruent to the original object. But every point of the image will be 2 down and 3 right of where it was before. If instead I ask you to translate the shape a distance of 7 squares in the direction east-northeast, then it's a little bit trickier. First, find where the distance of 7 takes you. That'll put it somewhere on a circle of radius 7. Now all we have to do is get the direction correct. It's halfway between east and northeast at 22.5 degrees. The image is congruent to the original object, but every point of the image is now 7 squares distance away, east-northeast of where it started. A rotation is a turn of a specified angle about a specific point called the center of rotation. The center of rotation must always be specified. Every point on the shape will remain at the same fixed distance from the center of rotation. For example, let's rotate this shape around the marked center of rotation at the bottom left of the shape. We'll rotate it 90 degrees clockwise. Sorry, even if you prefer digital watches, you still need to know which way clockwise or anti-clockwise is. The easiest way to do this is actually to cut the shape out of another piece of paper. Then you can literally hold the bottom left corner still and rotate the cutout shape around it. We want a quarter turn clockwise. Did you notice as we rotated it that each part of the shape moved in a circle around the center of rotation? Every point in the image is the same distance from the center as it was in the object. But the center of rotation doesn't have to be part of the object. Here's an example where the center of rotation is off to the right. We have to rotate it anti-clockwise 90 degrees. This is a little trickier, but again, let's get our cutout shape and rotate it around. Can you see the circles each point on the shape is following? Where are they centered? It may help you, if you're cutting the shape out, to include the center of rotation in the piece you cut. Then you can hold it still there as you rotate. And of course, the angle of rotation need not be 90 degrees. This one says to rotate 45 degrees clockwise. Getting the distances and positions right can be a bit harder. I really recommend you cut the shape out and literally pull it around. It really will help you. A reflection is a flip across a specified line. Every point in the shape will remain the same distance from that line, but on the other side. When the line is vertical or horizontal, it's usually fairly easy to do. The image is inverted, but we still say that it's congruent to the object. It's flipped over, but the angles and lengths are all still the same and are still in the same relationships with each other. A flipped over shape, an inverted shape, is still said to be congruent. But if the reflection line is at a different angle, it can be a bit trickier. What you have to do is use the definition of the reflection to work out where the image is. Each point is the same distance from the line, but on the other side. Any part of the shape on the line doesn't move, but every other point gets moved directly across the line to the same distance it was on its original side. Even points from the other side get moved across the line to the same distance they were. See? And the resultant image will be congruent to the object, but inverted. Again, if you prefer, you can cut the shape out and literally flip it over. Finally, transformations that change the size of the shape. This is variously called enlargement, reduction, dilation, or magnification. Generally, enlargement is for making the shape bigger, with a scale factor greater than 1, and reduction is for making it smaller, with a scale factor less than 1. However, the terms are more or less interchangeable. Each point in the shape has its distance from the center of enlargement changed by the same factor, called the scale factor. The word factor should remind you to multiply the length by the scale. The angles in the shape will stay the same, but the size will change. Every side's length will be bigger or smaller by the same scale factor. This one is difficult to do with a cutout because you can't really stretch the paper. So instead, you'll have to work out the points separately and then join them up. Take each point, and in this case, double each distance away from the center of enlargement. See how it works? The trickier ones, just do carefully. Double the vertical distance and double the horizontal distance. And there's the image. It's twice the size, but the angles and relationships haven't changed. We say the image is similar to the object. The same angles, but not the same lengths. It's similar, but not congruent. Let's try a reduction where the scale factor is smaller than 1. Here, every point's distance from the center has to be reduced to 1/3 of what it was. Lightly draw in the lines from the center to each point and measure 1/3 of the distance. Then connect them up. And there's the image, exactly 1/3 the size of the original. And of course, the center of enlargement doesn't have to be part of the shape, just like when we did rotation. But the process is exactly the same. Move each point 1.5 times the distance it currently is from the center of enlargement. And there's the image.